Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Tina. I'm a third year medical student in China. In today's video, I'm going to be answering your questions. Some days ago, I told you guys to send me some questions on Insta story and on my Snapchat. And some of you sent me some questions, so thank you. I'm sorry for being absent for the past 2 weeks. I'm currently in my exam period and my exams will last till the second week of January, so I'll be quite busy. Well, I decided I could do this sit down video. If this is your first time stopping by my YouTube channel, you're welcome. Please feel free to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Well, let's get into the video. The first question: how can I go to China for a summer course as a medical student? For example, emergency or any type. I am my last year in medical school and I want to go have more experience in another country. I am studying in Turkey. Well, to answer this question, it can be easy, but that is only if you understand Chinese language. If you don't understand Chinese language, coming to China for a medical course or internship will be of no use to you because the patients speak Chinese language. The doctors are proficient in Chinese language, although some of the doctors can speak English, but it will be very difficult for you to actually learn anything. We as medical students in China, we offer comprehensive Chinese as a course in the first 2 years. We also take medical Chinese as a course in the third year. So we have been groomed and prepared to actually be able to have our internship in a Chinese hospital in order to have our rotations and understand the patients, understand the doctors, and it's easier for us. But if you can speak Chinese language, you can get your visa to come to China. It's not going to be very difficult. All you need to do is go to a medical university. Like if you decide to come to my city, for example, go to the university, you know, make some friends, and together you guys can just go to the hospital. No one will ask you, are you a student of this school? No one actually question you. The doctors will just be willing to teach you because you're interested in learning. That's all. And since you can understand Chinese language, it will be so much easier for them. Our teachers, the doctors are so happy and excited when they see the students are able to speak Chinese language. It just makes them feel like, I can actually teach you. You can actually learn from me. So yes, that is it about clinical internship in China. If you're coming from a different country, if you can speak Chinese language, then get your visa and come. But if you can't speak Chinese language, then China is not the best place for you to come for your internship. The next question is, what is the curriculum structure and what do students get to do in the clinical posting? Well, I am currently finishing my third year of medical school. By March, I'll start my fourth year. And because medical school in China is for 6 years, from the fourth year, we start our clinical posting. I've already made a video about this, about the difference between medical schools in China and medical schools in the US and every other place in the world. So you can go check out that video up here. Now, in the fourth year, we start our clinical courses. So you take courses like Surgery 1, Traditional Chinese Medicine, you take Otolaryngology, you take Neurology, you take Ophthalmology, Dermatology. These are the courses you take for your fourth year, the first semester of your fourth year. And then the second semester of fourth year, you take courses like Surgery 2, Pediatrics, Gynecology, and then the fifth year, your first semester, you can take Internal Medicine, Emergency Medicine, so all these courses, and every other clinical related course. So all these courses are separated and they are all arranged for your fourth year and the first semester of your fifth year. So now, these are when you still have classes, you go to the hospital and you still go to classes. So now after your fifth year first semester, medical school is as good as over for you. you no more go to classes. Now it's time for your clinical internship. So some students can decide to, you know, go to different countries. Most people decide to go back home to their countries, decide to go to other countries because you have 1 year clinical internship here. And some people decide to actually do it in China. Now, if you're doing it in China, you're going to rotate every department possible. Yeah, it's going to be nephrology, it's going to be dermatology, it's going to be surgery, emergency medicine. Every department that you can think of, you're going to do all those departments if you're doing your clinical internship in China. And for the people that went back home, people that decided to go back home for internship, in particular, people that went back to Nigeria reported when they came back, they said they did their internship in 4 departments. They had internal medicine, surgery, OB-GYN, and one other course, I can't remember, but if I remember, I'll write it down here for you guys. All the courses, I'll write them on the screen for you guys to see. So now, these are the courses that we do for the clinical years in China. So from your 4th year to your 5th year, sorry, from your 4th year to your 6th year first semester, these are your clinical years. So after your internship, after doing all these courses, you come back to China, your last semester, you write your final graduation exam, and that's the end. You get your graduation certificate, and you leave. Go and soar, and get your life together, your medicine. Some people decide to do residency, some decide to do masters. Some people decide to stay back in China and do masters. So, that's it. The next question is very similar. Hi there, I had a doubt. Is there any language barrier during clinical internship? Like, how can one overcome the language barrier while studying medicine in China? And also, which medical school am I studying in? Okay, first of all, I study in Jinzhou Medical University, Liaoning Province, China. Now, clinical internship, like I said before, we have courses that teach us Chinese language, and from experience, from going out on the streets, making Chinese friends, we get to learn Chinese language. So, not everyone actually learns Chinese language in the classroom or on the streets. There are some people who actually just say, I don't feel like studying Chinese language, I didn't come to China to study Chinese language. And when they go to the hospital, and maybe the doctor and the patient are actually communicating, they are lost. They don't know what is going on. So usually, you find some other students that know Chinese better try to, you know, interpret to their friends, and the doctor also interprets in English. But also, you notice that the students that can speak Chinese language are at an advantage because, first of all, they already have first-hand information of what the patient and the doctor are talking about. So in order to break this barrier, you have to learn Chinese language. And the schools in China offer classes for you to learn Chinese language. We also write HSK. It's like Chinese exams. It's like how you write TOEFL and all these foreign English exams. This is a Chinese exam. You have to write it. And that's the only way to overcome the language barrier in the clinical internship, by learning the language. The next question, are your lessons given in English? Yes, guys, I study medicine in English. So many times I get this question, I study medicine in English. There are going to be times that you hear me and some of my classmates speak Chinese language in some of my vlogs, but it doesn't mean we study medicine in Chinese language. But, you know, we have clinical internship, we need to make our Chinese better, we need to understand it better. So any opportunity we have to practice Chinese language, speaking to our teachers, speaking to our friends, speaking to ourselves, we try to speak Chinese language just to learn the language and be able to communicate with Chinese people and prepare for our clinical rotations. But we study medicine in English language. The next question, what are the challenges of studying medicine in China? Well, I think everything about studying in China all has to do with the language, because that is the major challenge we face, Chinese language. being able to learn the language, how to understand the patients, how to communicate better with the doctors. It's all about the language. There are so many techniques and skills that a doctor has, and they want to, you know, teach it to the students, but they may not really be able to express themselves in English language. You know, there are some doctors that have maybe some special suturing techniques, some special ways to perform some surgeries that, you know, they created by themselves and they are good at. But when they want to, you know, when it's time to actually teach and, you know, explain, it gets, the language barrier just comes in. But students who understand Chinese language have broken this barrier, they are closer with their teachers, and they get more opportunities. Is studying medicine in China hard? Well, studying medicine in China is like studying medicine in any other place in the world, if you ask me. It's not so difficult that you can't overcome. You just have to study hard, you have to understand your teachers, know what they want you, know how your teachers set their questions. You need to be able to communicate with your teacher. You need to attend classes because so many important things are being said in class. So with all this, I can say studying medicine in China is as complex as it is, but you can overcome it. You can come out with very good grades. You can understand, you can study by yourself, get some extra information. In general, it is okay. Well, I hope I've been able to answer some of your questions. I don't want to make this video too long, but I've answered most of the questions that I can. If you have any more questions about studying in China or about my life in medical school, you can leave it in the comment section. If this video has helped you, if you've learned more about China and medicine and living in China, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you're already subscribed, please click the bell beside the subscribe button to get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any more questions, leave it in the comment section. And I finally want to wish you guys Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance. 2017 was an amazing year. Thank you guys for all your support, for following me throughout. Ever since I started YouTube, I will not be making this video without you guys' support, and I'm really grateful, and I hope you can make 2018 a better year. If you have any video ideas for 2018, any type of videos you want to see in 2018, please leave it in the comment section and I'll be glad to make the video for you guys. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in 2018. Bye bye.